7G.
Great morning, friends. We, the students of class 7G, are here to present our drama, The Waiter. Long ago in Denmark, there lived a boy by name John with his poor father. They had to work very hard to earn enough money to live. John ran errands. Errands are a short journey taken in order to deliver or collect something, especially on someone's behalf. In one of the errands, John's honesty and truthfulness is tested. So fasten your seatbelts to see how John's honesty is tested.
Great morning, friends. The drama, The Waiter, is a folk tale from Denmark. Many years ago, in Denmark, there lived a poor father with his son in a small cottage. They had to work hard to earn enough money to live. The father worked as labor and his son John ran errands. One hot summer day, the son was sent long distance to deliver the letter.
Well, John, another day. I see you later. Maybe tonight we can have tea and talk.
That would be great. I have a long way to go to deliver this letter. Maybe I can even say whatever God wish we could have some fun sometime. Don't worry about me, Bell. I get better get going if I'm going to get this letter delivered by today. See you, John.
Nikita. Why don't you stay tonight?
We can talk and just know each other better.
I suppose my master would not like to ride his favorite horse back home in the dark.
Of course not. I'll be sure to ride up at early in the morning so that you can leave without any delay.
Excuse me.
This should do the trick. Please get one of the bedrooms ready for our guests. Please be staying here tonight.
Yes, my lady.
I like having guests on the estate. Guests only when my father is away. By the way, what's your name? How did you come by the shop?
Yes, very good, my lady. Well, my name is John. I live in a village with my father. As I said, I got this job from the Lord of Oz yesterday. And I'm so lucky to have a full-time job. Now, I and my father have to not worry about the money, and I get interesting people to like you, my lady.
What a gallant thing to say.
Sorry to interrupt, my lady, but I want to let you know that the room is ready for our guests.
Thank you, you're gonna try now.
Yes, my lady.
My goodness, it's already after midnight. I'm tired. What about you?
Please stay a bit longer. It's so rare to have someone in the estate who has seen many interesting places. Tell me of your journey here. How was it to ride a fine horse all the way from Mostagar?
I did not ride it the whole way. Actually, I did not want to make it tired, so I walked next to him.
You then ride your horse?
Yeah, he said he did not bark at all.
I would love to ride that horse. He sounds like a gentle horse. Will you leave a horse with me so that I can ride it and keep it as my own?
No, really, it's not mine to give you.
Oh, please, your masters will have so many fine horses. Wouldn't mind if one was given to me?
No, I cannot.
John, please, just go and ride your horse. The master was always so good to our family. Surely you will mind.
I'm not sure, but maybe.
Just think, then you come with your horse a lot of times. You can talk and you can each other better.
Okay, you can have the horse.
This means so much to me. Thank you. I will show you the room now.
I can't believe I gave away my master's house to that beautiful maiden last night. What I'm going to tell my master now? I'll say the bandits stole the horse. I'm so lucky to be alive.
John, you know you can't get from your master.
I suppose you're right. What? Did you talk?
Sure he did, but that doesn't mean his purposes. John, don't be stupid. You will know what if he likes. Besides, what would your father think if he get fired?
He would be disappointed. What? Did you do talk?
John, don't listen to that hurried talk. You know very well the Lord of Ashoka hired you. How can you lie to him?
You're right.
What does a tree know for the sake of horseman off? Be brave and worthy. Don't be a fool and keep your job and make something up.
I'm going out of mind. What should I do? What should I do?
So friends, what would you do? Do you listen to the trees or the dog?
Good morning, friends.
John was of good heart and kept his father cooked and loving.